If you are just a morning time bulletin, like it's your first time or anything, you'll be trembling. Everyone thinks sitting behind the camera, it's easy to sit in front of the camera and question someone else. But it's equally difficult. You should be able to form your questions in your mind and at the same time question it. There will be someone feeding you written questions or whatever. Someone might be prompting you in the other ear. You're hearing the other person in the other. So it's a very tedious job. So if you are a good reporter, this thing becomes very much easy for you to do. Then there are producers. Now, what's the job of a producer? A producer is, you know, he will make sure, he is the editorial coordinator basically between the reporter and the technical group. And he will make sure how good it comes, how easy it goes to the consumer so that they can consume it very easily. When it comes to graphics, for example, you see these flashy graphics and everything. So it's the producer who has designed it, not the anchor. The producer thinks, okay, when you see now, there are a lot of tackier graphics day in, day out that you see on television. There's a bus running or something like that. So everyone has started doing it. But that's what catches the eye for us. If we put that kind of a graphic, like polluting factories or something like that, then you'll see the factories being there or something like that. And it catches the eye. Then there's the stamping, rejected, alleged or corrupted, those stamping happens or something like that. So these are all imaginations of the producer. So when a rundown producer writes these things, which is the desk producer, he will write all these things. Okay? He will write the graphic. Okay? So and so is the pointer. But how to present that pointer? If I put it as a PPT, like pointers just coming, you will get bored. Like for instance, if you keep on seeing a business news channel, the type of graphics, the graphics, which you're like, boss, what is this happening? Like, just come on, feed it to me. Like, normal news has to be that way. It has to be fed to the consumer. Like you have to, it has to be that point that he has to just gulp it now. It has to be that level. So that's what the producer does. Then apart from that, there's the technical team. Now the technical team is very important. Like you see these windows which happen, there's wipes which come and everything. So those are part of the guys, the technical guys, the switcher, the sound guys, then there's the whiz, is what the engine we call, which is the graphics engine. So that's another person. So these are also part of journalism, because you should be knowing what is happening. It shouldn't be, it's not just generic knowledge that you have. Like there are a lot of switchers, a lot of sound guys, a lot of whiz guys who have the knowledge about what's right now happening in news. Like they very much follow it, who's the spokesperson from that point. Like suddenly you get a bite, the producer doesn't have the time to put like, okay, this is like Ravi Shankar Prasad or whatever like that, and the visibility guy sees, okay, it's Ravi Shankar, he types it out and he puts it, because he has to know who the guy is. So that is also a very important role, like at what time what graphic goes. Like sometimes it happens, the anchor, like, you know, these guys ad-lib a lot of things which are not a part of graphic template or something like that. So when there is one graphic running, he will send out a tweet, like a message. These guys send out messages while they're anchoring actually, and they'll send out a message, they'll send us a thing, then they'll do actions like, okay, make a lower third. So we have to realize it. So this is all happening off camera actually. We make sure that you don't see all these theatrics which are happening, while actually in the live bulletin this actually happens. They make these gestures like put it in a window. So okay, we have to get window. Okay, yeah, so get a window ready immediately. So all these templates are ready, but sometimes what happens is on the field it's all shaky. So you have to get the window right, that kisi ka sar na kat jaye, kisi ka ye na ho jaye. So that has to be done. So that is what the technical team does. And apart from that, technical production and the camera person. So this is what happens in the studio. Now, in the bulletin, there are a lot of reporter lives, a lot of guest lives which happen. So what are these reporter lives? So reporters are, like we have a thumb rule in CNN, a reporter live, for a reporter to be live, the reporter has to be through with sound and audio check for around 10 minutes before it goes on air. But in Hindi channels, it is half an hour, 45 minutes, 1 hour, they keep the person ready without taking the live. So that also happens. So there are two extremes. It's about how professional you want to be. So some channels prefer to, like, the reporter has to 10 minute pehla khada kar do. Why he has to stand half an hour and standing like this? Then you see a lot of, when there are multiple windows during elections or something like that, you'll see all the reporters like doing that. So they are unaware, like they are in the window or whatever like that. So that's why it is, sometimes what we do is we cheat that also. We record it and it's in the loop and you don't realize when they're looking in the camera. But when we cut to them, they're actually live. So those are the kind of tricks also that are played while making a news bulletin. Then apart from that, coming to the show that I do, The Week That Wasn't. So Week That Wasn't is a satirical news show about the news which happens. And it's more of a late night combined with the daily news. And that's how we mix it. So that's why there are several characters that come on the show, or caricatures that Kunal plays or Gopal plays or I play for that matter. And these characters are like the guests which come on the show. And so we have a Sharad Pawar, we have a Mayawati or something like this. So right, recently we did a fake interview with Anupam Kher. So Anupam Kher had appeared on our channel. He had given a live to another reporter. It was an actual this thing. So we pick up that live and we deconstruct it and question it in such a way, write the questions so his answers become funny. So that's another take, how to do that. Apart from that, when you do satire nowadays in our country, you have to be, and prior to that also, but you have to be very much careful you don't hurt anyone's sentiments. So which are very much on the rise nowadays. So people get offended very easily. So you have to be very careful. So now here where the wordplay comes in. So we always introduce someone, we have an alleged spokesperson. So this word alleged is, so tomorrow if anyone gets up, he's like, oh, boss, we have said it's alleged, he couldn't be also. But now how we decide on what topic to do. So when we sit in the, like in the morning meeting kind of a thing, which is like 6 o'clock in the morning, because both Cyrus and Kunal are morning people. So earlier in the night, we start developing 2-3 ideas as to what we should do. Cause ultimately when we make, nowadays we make this daily snippets of 5-5 minutes, which combine into a half an hour show over the weekend. So the daily show is called The News That Wasn't. So we shoot it Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday. So every day is a new topic. But when you decide that topic, you have to be very careful that this topic is relevant on a Saturday to the person who's watching on television. The web guy has consumed it, but the television guy, it should be so relevant that he should consume it. So when we decided, like for instance this week, we started the week Monday, the SPBSP happened over the weekend. It's like what to do. So 15th Jan is Mayawati's birthday. So we clubbed that into a gag and made Kunal into Mayawati and did it on a Monday. So that gag can repeat on a weekend. And BSP-SP alliance, keeping the Congress out, is a very big story comparatively in a bigger UP state. And so that remains the big story. So then we move on to a Tuesday. Tuesday, what to do. So this BSP strike was very much on that time. So now this strike or anything like, or buns are temporary. By the time we have shot it on Tuesday, it got called off on a Wednesday afternoon. So when we shoot it in such a way that it has that relevance. Now, and that's the thing we have to decide. Like when you show it over the weekend, we'll say, okay, earlier we spoke to this person and he said this. And so that you don't have to reshoot the gag. Or else you have to remember this wordplay. Like when you shot with Kunal also for Mayawati, he said because 15 January is Mayawati's birthday. But when we use the version on the weekend, it's this week was Mayawati's birthday. So you will get the relevance very much there when you see it on television also and on web at the same time. So on Tuesday we shot the BST gag. Then on Wednesday, what more topic? There was like literally nothing happening. Like what? Then we started, we like stumbled upon this Kumbh Mela. Okay, now it's a religious thing. What to do about Kumbh Mela? What should we do? The Naga Sadhus or whatever. Because we had done Naga Sadhus and all in the past. Like, let's not touch it. Then there was the whole Kinnar having the bath and everything. So like where you should go, where you... So like we did the we took a very safer and funnier thing, which is the kumbh mein mera bhai kho gaya tha angle, and we did the Ramesh and Suresh angle to it. So there's this foreigner who has come and he's like searching for him, and it's Gopal playing, and it's a double role, and then he pulls out the 5-star and everything like that, and that's how the gag happens. Then there is on Thursday, like, what to do? Hardik Pandya and KL Rahul was still a major issue which was happening. So, okay, Hardik Pandya, KL Rahul, what to do? Now, we shoot at around 10 o'clock in the morning. A lot of news develops post that. So, you have to make sure that your product is so good that it will be still relevant despite whatever big news you have. Like, yesterday, I think so, the dance bar judgment came, which came around in the afternoon. Everyone was like, oh, boss, what has happened? Like, sometimes we connect with our colleagues in Delhi and we ask, are boss, koi bada matter hone wala hai kya? Is Rahul Gandhi traveling anywhere? Is Modi traveling anywhere? So then we make these gags about, like, Kunal plays Modi, he travels, like, he has traveled to some place or something like that. So that's how it happened. So I wanted to show if we can put the Gopal gag. So how we did the double role, I want to show you guys, like, how a double role is done in that. So if you see, I put this music, that sitar thing, so you know, it gives you that spiritual, the sentiment which is running. So like this is enhancing the edit. So when you see it in a flat, he's saying, then there's a lot of silence. There's a lot of pause in between. So how you cover up the pause? Like television in visual media, pauses to a point are okay, but everyone used to sleep when Atal Bihari used to talk also. Long pauses are not always welcome. And you have to dramatize certain things. So we are dramatizing, this is how you dramatize a certain gag or anything that you're doing.
Yeah, it's all right. Namaste, namaste. Ew.
Yeah, again, I hate to interrupt you. I know this is a very spiritual moment for you, but what is your name, sir?
I'm Yogi Anand. Anand Ramesh.
You sound like...
From California.
All the way from California?
Yes. I was only 5 years old when my parents brought me here for the first time. It was the most eye-opening time in my life.
Wow, you were 5 years old when you were brought from California to the Kumbhela for the first time. Interesting.
Also, was where my sight was where my sight first began. After that, I have come here every 4 years.
So what is that search for? So what was that search for, Anand?
My search for what everyone comes to the Kumbh Mela for.
That's what I don't understand. What?
Don't you watch Hindi films, Bollywood?
No, I do. What are you searching for here in the Kumbh Mela? Come on, be frank, be open, come on.
I have come in search for my lost brother.
Lost brother?
My lost twin brother. We lost him here. In the Kumbh Mela, when we were just 5, I come looking for him every year, every year.
So again, the sarangi is because of that, like in the old 80s film, like any emotional, like that dipping sound has, so it has to create that theatrical.
Yes, come on, brother, come get my brother every year. Ramesh? Suresh?
Then again the happy tone.
Ramesh!
So when we got, so this is how we done. We have got the similar like physical appearance looking guy with the same wig to go and hug him. Now there is a goof up in this shoot, which only if you have observed it, like if you have seen it for the first time, so you won't realize it. But if you see it over and over again, there is one technical goof up in it. If anyone can point it out, I can slightly rewind and show it to you.
My lost twin brother. We lost it here.
It's a technical issue.
When we were just five, I come looking for him every year.
Brother?
Yes, my brother. Come get my brother every year. Ramesh,
it's called the axis jump. There's an axis jump in it. So if you go to see, if I'll show you by frame by frame. So this is, he comes, hugs him. Actually, if you see here, it's like flipping. The frame flips. The angle should have been, instead of him hugging this way, like the camera angle should be this way. That's the only goofer, but it doesn't make a difference because it has happened in a such a fast motion, the switch is, that you won't realize it. We have kept it that fast, but we realize it later. Now, coming back to the Anupam Kher thing, No, ideally, if it's a serious interview, then it's a problem. Like, the, sometimes axis jumps happen. Like, in this over-the-shoulder shots is where axis jumps happen. And it comes when you're shooting this over the shoulder, like a sit down interview or something like that. So you should be careful. Like you might be shown, or I don't know if any in the camera class they might have shown about the axis jump thing. So axis jump is very important, because like suppose two people are sitting, like if you are saying Rajiv's interview or something like that. So Rajiv sits and the other person sits. So this camera picks me up, the other camera picks him up. This camera, now this is the axis. What you two people, what the anchor and the guest sits is the axis. If it shifts from here to here, then both the anchor and the this one will be on the left side of the frame. Okay. Now you see one is on the left, one is on the right. So that is the axis.
So who has made that mistake?
No, so while shooting in a hurry, we didn't realize it, we shot it that way. So when we came to the edit table, it was already shot and we are done with the gag. And like, oh, like shit. Because it was Gopal playing the double role, then because we shoot in a new studio, there are a lot of things which are back to back happening. So after us, there was a bulletin which was supposed to be rolled. So the chroma had to be brought down, the set had to be put up. So it's a very short window that we shoot it in. So we then tried to salvage it somehow, but then it would have screwed the whole gag, so that's why we stick to it, like, it's okay. It's not that much of a difference because it's a much wider shot. If it was close to close cutting, then it's more of a jump to the visual eye. Like, this one is the... So these are multiple takes that we...
Just relax. Anupam, it's me, yeah, we're friends. Oh, we won't talk about it. Let's start the interview again. Let's just have a normal, decent interview. Come on. Much better. I'll also give a look. Anupam Kher, welcome to the show.
Haji, namaskar.
Namaskar. Namaskar twice. People are saying that the film is politically motivated. Question number one.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's what you're saying in defense. But they're also saying the film is copied from Rohit Shetty's Simba.
बोलने दीजिए, आपको क्या फर्क पड़ता
है?
तो अच्छी बात है, आई थिंक इट्स फैंटास्टिक.
Let me and the viewer understand this. Accidental Prime Minister is actually like Simba. It's a Rohit Shetty sort of film. Does it have any action sequences? Does it have cars flying? Rahul Gandhi flying? Sonia Gandhi flying?
Yeah.
You watch this film. I'm going to watch this film. Is it really that kind of film?
Is desh mein aap kuch bhi kar sakte hain?
Answer reply. Is desh mein aap kuch bhi kar sakte hain? Is that an expression from the film? Very interesting. So when you were making Accidental Prime Minister, what is the biggest lesson that you learned?
आप प्रधानमंत्री को गाली दे सकते हैं.
Oh, you mean ex प्रधानमंत्री, but not the current प्रधानमंत्री. Drinking water, not answering. You like it? I like it.
आखिरी सवाल.
आखिरी सवाल. Hey, you can't keep wanting to run away every time I ask you a slightly tough question. Come on.
Say that again.
You're pretending you can't hear, yeah. You think I don't know all this? I've been doing this from college days. You obviously didn't like what I said, sir.
आप कुछ भी बोल सकते हैं freedom of expression के नाम पर.
That's what we're doing this show. Let's go. How do you think people feel when we, as an audience, watch this film?
It will make you uncomfortable.
Like how I feel now here on this show. Uncomfortable? Why? Are the seats small?
Yeah.
Okay. What else? Popcorn and cold drinks available or not?
Why not? Of course.
Don't make me uncomfortable. Okay, now how are the other performances in the film? Come on, you rate them.
Buy the ticket and see.
Give us a hint, a small trailer.
No, this is not the way I want to.
Okay, no need to get upset. No need to get upset. Why don't we just talk about your performance, as Manmohan Singh. Give us a sample of that performance. Great. And action? Excuse me, what's... Nothing is happening, Anupam. You're not even saying anything, you're not doing anything. You're completely... How much? I get it. This is the performance. This is the title, the Silent Prime Minister. I get it. Super, what a performance. Brilliant! Are you going to show Dr. Manmohan Singh this film?
Yeah.
I see. What do you think he'll be thinking after he sees the film?
It's hurtful. It's also upsetting.
One shouldn't go below the belt. Are you going to show the film to Rahul, Priyanka, Sonia?
Yeah.
When?
After 50 years.
But when is the film releasing?
On 15th August, 26th January, or Eid, or Diwali, or New Year's Eve.
Add 7th August also to it. It's my birthday. Anyway, I'll leave that right there. But one last question. In your final analysis, who is the best Prime Minister this country has ever had?
Dr. Manmohan Singh.
Oh. Excellent. I don't know if that's acting or... But excellent. One last small question, BS so to speak. Is it true Dosana 3 will star you with Nasiruddin Shah?
So if you go to see, there are... couple of shorts where there are two EPs coming out. So we used a Hindi channel live also and an English channel live. And that's how we combined it, because getting these noddies in the two windows and everything. So it's a trick, his expression. So when you sit for the interview, like we note down where he has expressed something, like looking down, like the eyebrows going up or anything. So these are very crucial things when you try to do such kind of an interview. So it's where... it comes off really well when you, it's like actually he has done those interviews and he has actually like answered those kind of questions. That's what people feel. Then there are a couple of gags that we have done together, and how is like when we do it, like a co-actor working with a co-actor. So when we shoot a gag, our gags are shot in mostly under two takes we just do. So that's the thing. So you have to be very, so we read the script and everything, but it's about when you do it with someone else, when you're doing it, if the other person is putting the whole energy in it and you're not able to do it, then it's a problem. Yes. So Kunal actually writes the whole script, like combines it together. Cyrus comes up with pointers, and Cyrus, me and Kunal, we decide a topic or come up with pointers, and Kunal then construct the whole script. That's how it happens. And then, so there's this one gag, which I wanted to show you. It's which is a very old one. And think of. Unfortunately, me in it. So this was when Yogi had announced the Romeo Squad in UP.
Namaskar, I am the hunt for Romeos, like myself. Now I tell you, the cops in UP are probably working the hardest they ever have, and joining us from Lucknow are Constables Gopal Sharma and his first cousin by law, Mohit Verma. Sarjis, Sarjis.
Namaste ji, namaste. Hum hai Constable Gopal Sharma. और हम सूर्य नमस्कार कर रहे थे।
But there was supposed to be two of you, Sharma ji and Verma ji. Where's your colleague?
आ रहे हैं। आप 1, 2, 3 बोलिएगा, वो आ जाएंगे। बोलिए, चलिए 1, 2, 3 बोलिए।
Okay, 1, 2, 3.
हल्के हल्के, slowly. सांस लीजिए। ये देखिए, आ गए Verma ji. Verma नमस्कार कीजिए।
नमस्कार। हो गया सूर्य नमस्कार
सो योर Because it is Lucknow, the background that we had taken, that's why we had to source the clothes also like the UP police wears. Like you can't be wearing the Hawaldar clothes or, because they wear this dark khaki on the top and a light khaki as the short as the pants. So we had to source that. So we have this gem dress wala in Andheri, whom we call up, and like I've been hounding him over now 11 years. Now it's on a phone call. So he's like, aap phone mat kijiye, aap ye bhej dijiye, photo bhej dijiye, usse sabse main bhejta hu. Now the over the years the problem is I have gained weight. Everyone else have grown bigger, but his clothes haven't. So we have to, it's all very much tight and like a body fitting clothes that you happen to see. So this was one of the memorable gags. A lot of people from Hindi speaking people liked it.
You can call us Sawarma.
I would never say that. I've lost my appetite.
देखिए अब कहा है मुख्यमंत्री जी ने कहा है सूर्य नमस्कार सेहत के लिए बहुत अच्छा होता है इसलिए हम हर सुबह उठ के सूर्य नमस्कार करते
हैं हाउ मेनी सूर्य नमस्कार डू यू डू
शर्मा जी पूरा एक सूर्य नमस्कार करते हैं और हम उससे थोड़ा कम
लेस देन 1 इट डजंट सीम लाइक एबिलिटी टू एक्सरसाइज
गोपाल सर पौना व्हिच इज अ एड लिब Complete. So the dialogue is hum thoda, main thoda kam. So he has said pauna karte. So that's all ad lib. So there are a lot of ad libs like Cyrus does now over the years we have started doing is because it's in the spur of the moment. In the second take, whether it will happen or not, like with Cyrus, when we shoot with him, it's the first take and that is the best take that you'll get. The second take is then he'll get conscious about what he has said in the earlier take or forget it or something like that. So we make sure that everything is perfect when we do the first take.
Very worth talking about. So let's go to the big policing issue in UP besides the meat crackdown, the anti-Romeo squad, sir.
देखिए यूपी का पुलिस जो है दो टाइप का काम करता है एक तो चोरों को पकड़ना और दूसरा छोरों को पकड़ना
चोरों को और छोरों को आपका समझ
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I get the joke.
अच्छा
हाँ How do you recognize the Romeo by just looking at him?
हाँ अच्छा सवाल पूछे हैं आप जैसे if you see a young man who is not eating pan masala or gutka वो साला रोमियो है
really
the only time a UP guy doesn't have pan masala in his mouth is when he wants to impress a girl झट करके अरेस्ट करते हैं हम क्यों चुप रहिए आप
Vermaji looks a little confused now. Please explain. How do you, Vermaji? You explain. How do you recognize a roadside Romeo? Huh?
देखिए हमारे पास भी एक ट्रिक है.
I see what trick.
देखिए हम छोरों को पकड़ते हैं और सीधा पूछ लेते हैं.
क्या पूछते हो?
हैं? Is your name Mr. Romeo? अरे हाँ बोले तो अरेस्ट कर लेते हैं नहीं बोले तो छोड़ देते हैं
चुप रहिए
Is your name Mr. Romeo? And How many have you raised?
Zero. वो क्या है यूपी में बहुत कम लोगों का नाम रोमियो होता है राम प्रसाद बहुत मिल जाते हैं
वर्मा जी बस स्टॉप
सो सर लुक्स फूल प्रूफ टू मी बट टेल मी द बोथ ऑफ यू What is the idea behind this crackdown?
देखिए जी साइरस जी ये अच्छा है हम बता रहे हैं आपको काफी अच्छा है
कैसा अच्छा है
देखिए देखिए हम बताते हैं एंटी रोमियो स्क्वाड वांट्स यंग मेन टू रिमेन सिंगल बिकॉज़ इट बिलीव्स दैट सिंगल मेन बिकम सक्सेसफुल इन लाइफ
I'm not single. Who said that?
Because if you are single, you can become the CM of UP or PM of India.
Anyway, you may have a point, but what about you, Varmaji? What do you think is the idea behind this anti-Romeo squad?
देखिए हमारे मुताबिक इसका अलग भी कारण है.
क्या कारण है?
In UP, we have anti-Romeo squad because UP government, I think, hates the Shakespeare.
कैसी बातें कर रहे हैं गंदी गंदी बातें मत क्या कीजिए इंटरव्यू चल रहा है शेक्सपियर ये भूल जाइए कुछ नहीं कहे हैं वर्मा जी इसको काट दीजिएगा
शेक्सपियर
like that's now taking pot shots at like PM or Yogi so we have done that in the past but you have to maintain that like if you see if you compare our show to a stand up it's completely different it's like none of the jokes you will find are below the belt or anything or obnoxious so to say I don't think so any of our gags are so off will offend anyone in that sense like that's the core behind keeping it funny and you know you can go out and give galis or whatever or express yourself or you know use curse word to describe your whatever you're performing or use bad words in whatever you're performing but that's not gonna it can be done in another different way the way we do it by not using any bad words or anything like that and like certain topics that we refrain from doing like if there is a blast or something like that where there are a lot of casualties which have taken place or something like that so it's better to stay away from it because that is no matter what it can't be funny or it shouldn't be joked around with now be it your army or be it anyone for that matter so those are the kind of things that we have done and apart from that any questions till now any question ha yep.
So can you take now you are the other producers maybe sir, can you take us through the day that you go through with you and your team
yeah
when you plan a show and maybe
so how much team there producing this project
So I am the producer. There's a assistant on the show, and Kunal, Cyrus, and Gopal. That's the editorial production team. And apart from that, there's a technical team of 4 to 5 guys. So this is the lowest way we can produce a show like this. And coming to your question, so our day starts very early in the day. Like I get up at 6 o'clock, 6:30, and we start discussing like. Kunal has already started writing the gag or whatever like that because prior day we decide like okay tomorrow we should be doing this topic or that topic or something like that then we write down certain pointers to it like certain gags or like one lines so the one lines then you construct it into a dialogue form and that's how you use it so once we come to the office we read it sit together do a reading like Cyrus reads it if I'm acting I'll read it if Gopal is acting he'll read it to get a you know so whatever an ad lib also might pop up at that time so we immediately added into the script that there will be this one like ek cheez kar di so ye cheez agar include karenge to aur acha lagega gag mein so that's how then we add that acha okay this is also coming off well so we can use this like a lot of time Gopal comes up with this various ideas about doing like इधर ये गाना डाल देते हैं उधर ये कर देते हैं लेट मी एक्ट लाइक दिस और समथिंग लाइक दैट सो दैट ब्रिंग्स आउट अ डिफरेंट कैरेक्टर टू द गैग दैट वी आर डूइंग एंड आफ्टर द रीडिंग इज डन यूजुअली वी व्हाट वी डू इज वी शूट साइरस फर्स्ट सो साइरस गोज इन टू शूट एज द एंकर लिंक इज डन फर्स्ट बिकॉज इट्स ऑन द सेट एंड एवरीथिंग लाइक दैट सो वी शूट हिम फर्स्ट सो व्हाट एवर सो व्हेन वी शूट इफ यू गो टू सी इन ऑल द गैग्स देयर आर दिस पॉजेस इन द टू विंडो Like no one is saying it's not like he has sat and tuck done the line. So when he's in the studio and doing his lines in the EP, we read at the same time the other lines. So that's how he's reacting to it. So he's taking those pauses. Like when he does the stand up, I laugh at the stand up. So then he takes that pause. Like in certain like in the anchor, there's a drumbeat which is coming, or laughter, wherever the laughter, where only Cyrus is talking, where laughter is coming and he is not talking, is done because I have given him the feedback that someone will be laughing. But the idea is again not to get thrown off by it. Like if you're performing and someone laughs in your ear, you're like, sorry, like, so that's how you should get used to it, which is equally for a news anchor. When if you want to become an anchor, there will be continuous some chatter in your ear. Most of the time it's off, but during breaking news it is on. A lot of people get thrown by it, so some people don't prefer it, some people prefer it, but it's better to get used to it, because it can happen. Because if you are out on the field and there's a lot of commotion and you are on a live, like the reporter stand, and there's something happening, like imagine the reporters who were reporting on 26/11 for that matter, there was firing happening when they were reporting on the phone line. So those kind of situations also arise in life of a reporter. Coming back to the episode, so after we are done with the anchor links of Cyrus, then we shoot the chroma, because the makeup takes a lot of time if there are get-ups or something like that. So for that we design this like the backgrounds. If you go to see, we figure out how the background should look, or it should give a feel or something like that. It shouldn't look so off also, okay, alag hi hai, chroma hi hai, ye lagna nahi chahiye. So how to light it up at the same time to make it feel like if it's a night background, to thoda night yellowish light jo street light ka aata hai. So those are the kind of things, and make that frame, and then Cyrus feeds his lines from inside to the other guy, and that's how we get the pauses and the timing when we do it. And that's why when we do it, we get the time to put the laughter and everything over there.
How much time you take?
So the shoot time actually is around, consider like pre-production and shoot, around 3 hours since the morning. Like we meet at around 8 o'clock, 8:30 kind of, 8:30 to around 11:30, and by 11:30 we are done with the 5 minute chunk, shooting the 5 minute chunk. Then after that the editor comes in and then he starts assembling the edit. Now if you go to see every news, like whatever, there's an anchor read first. So the anchor read will be about what the story is, and now we are going to talk to someone, because that's how you set up the gag. So this is the thing, and now you are going to talk about it. So that's how the whole setup happens. So that is also important, because if you just joining us now, so and so, the guy who hasn't seen the news won't know what the gag is about. Okay, later he might catch on to it, but if you give a setup to that. So when you deliver a stand-up or anything, they say, okay, there is setup and then there is the punch. So you don't have to explain it. Like we always say, okay, let's not explain a joke. Like let's leave it to the imagination type, okay, he should get it. Like, because then it's diluting the joke and literally feeding it sometimes. So that's why we keep it in such a way.
Minds. We give you Kim Jong-un and of no minds.
So yeah, year end best. So best of 2018.
Sir.
Now if you go to see, we shot it in the behind the chroma that you see is basically when we shot him, he's sitting on a normal chair. This is the background, and the background was green when we shot it. So the video has been added in post. So when we shoot it, because we have a news channel setup, we have a switcherboard. The switcherboard can key chroma directly. So when you shoot, you won't be able to, like when you do, like if you go on to do ad film shoot or film shoots or anything like that, they shoot it on green directly into the camera, and then they if you are using, I think so, Adobe, you might have been shown, no, Adobe Premiere. So then you key it in the Premiere. But here, because we have this technology available to us, we key it and directly shoot it. and that's how you can light it in the way we want it or whatever like that. And then we have added this video that we had found out. So this is the one that we
on the sidelines of the summit in Manila, PM and US President Donald Trump, joining us now, a lead spokesperson for both the PM and for Donald Trump. Please, we don't know if they are the real people or not, so do not contact us. Let's have a dramatized look at what happened at that historical meeting.
Let's have a look at dramatized look.
Mitra Donald.
So both the characters is Kunal.
Happy to see you today. Shall we stand up and hug as usual? I don't think so, because it's huge, it's huge. So, if it is huge moment, should we not get up and hug each other? I am not talking about the moment. I am talking about my stomach. It's huge, it's huge. If we hug, it will come in the way. I understand that. I understand that your stomach is like Hardik Patel. Always comes in the way. Hardik, did you say Hardik? Hardik comes in the way. Yes, it is a popular name in Gujarat. Hey, I love Gujarat. I love all Gujaratis. They all voted for me for our change. I also love all Gujaratis. Although I'm not sure they are going to vote for us right now. They're great people. They're great people, the Gujaratis in the US. All the Gujaratis, huge in New Jersey, huge in Jackson Heights, and the amazingly Gujaratis, huge in Vincennes County, especially in Edison, huge in Edison. That is very true. All Gujaratis are huge in Edison. But not only in Edison, also subtraction, multiplication, and division. Anything to do with numbers. Hey, that's a great job, a huge job, a beautiful job. Yeah. It is not a zone. It is the truth. Anyway, let us get down to talking business. Zara, dhanda ni baat karoge? Shall we talk business? Let's go business. I've had a great trip, a huge trip. It's been huge. Yes, I believe you have been in Asia for nearly 3 weeks. Yes, I have traveled for nearly 3 weeks now. It's a huge visit. I visited nearly all parts of China. That is very good to hear. Very good. Which parts of China did you visit? I was in Beijing, in Hong Kong, Korea, Japan, Vietnam, Philippines, nearly all parts of China. Trump bhai, I think you're making a mistake. Korea, Japan, Vietnam and Philippines are not part of China. They are separate countries. It's a huge mistake. It's a huge mistake. How can they all be different countries? They all look Chinese.
Now, luckily we don't say in that country that we can make a racist joke. But again, this has been shot. Same actor. It's the same frame that you can't change the camera magnification or even the position of the camera. And that's how we got this to be perfect and him also sitting. So this has been one take with him and one take with him. It's a one single take. It's not multiple takes or anything like that. So this is now all this takes, first of all, planning. And then it's about we have to do it in that certain pattern or something like that and get it right. Then there's this one gag, like, because of editorial importance, I want to show you this one gag, which is about the Congress's, when Congress lost in the election, the state election which happened recently. So this is a gag when which Cyrus and Gopal has written together completely. And
जैसा हमने कहा कांग्रेस पार्टी बहुत पुरानी पार्टी है ये पार्टी हमारे बाप दादाओं के जमाने से चली आ रही है
व्हाट डज दैट इवन मीन कम ऑन
अरे मतलब इसका बाप अभी कांग्रेस पार्टी में है पहले है इसका बाप चीफ मिनिस्टर बनेगा फिर उसके बाद इसको चीफ मिनिस्टर बनने का चांस मिलेगा
आई सी वाओ कौन
कहा था ना आपसे कांग्रेस पार्टी हमारे बाप दादा के जमाने से चली आ रही है
Basically, you're saying that only after your father, your father becomes chief minister, then you may have a chance.
पहले हो गया उसने दादाओं की पार्टी इसका दादा मतलब मैं अभी तक कांग्रेस में हूँ पहले मैं चीफ मिनिस्टर बनूंगा फिर मेरा बेटा बनेगा उसके बाद उसका बेटा बनेगा
नहीं पहले मैं चीफ मिनिस्टर बनूंगा नहीं पहले मैं चीफ मिनिस्टर बनूंगा पहले आप अपने बाप से पूछ लीजिए
But again, we have done the looks that we shot it with is purposely for the window purpose. That he is looking from one window to the other, and it has been shot in that manner. So, when you do these kind of, when you shoot these kind of gags, you have to do this study as to when you shoot this, how. So the main, the middle, what middle generation has to be in middle, and the elder and the young. So, aisa khelna chahiye uske saath. No, so when we read the script, then we discuss how we shoot it. So when we read, so when it's a single thing, it's much easier. But now this is this visual thing develops the gag, makes it more funnier because they're looking at each other kind of a thing when they're actually not, and it gives more fun. Actually, one second, I'll find out that episode, which is a more editorially funny episode. I can find it. One second.
Who influences Google itself? A man who has all the answers, having framed all the questions in the first place. Ladies and gentlemen, this man. I feel shame today, ladies and gentlemen. I feel pain. I feel angst. I feel frustration. Because India, your country, your motherland, has been robbed. Ladies and gentlemen, I ask you this. India has been robbed of her senses. You.
So, if you go to see now, in keeping with this thing, where there's a R dot, we have used a C dot. Instead of the debate, the rebate or something like that. The blue, more in the window kind of a thing. So the graphic, you know, the whole visual graphic gives you a...
You should be ashamed of yourself.
Yeah.
You should be ashamed. You know what you've done this year. It's just absolutely terrible. To vote out the ruling party from the center in five states left to lose. It's unbelievable. Of course, let me tell you, there are reasons for this, which I will come to. Sinister forces behind all this. And mind you, we have traced all this in letters that I have here. Letters from various people across the world. Lots of people from Interpol downwards are involved. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to break hearts today, but I'm also going to break minds. Because I'm going to make you understand what's behind this debacle in the five election scam. That, yes, I call it a scam. I do call it a scam. A five election scam that has just taken. Let's meet our leading cephologists. Here they are, two cephologists. First, Sun Singh Sarnal. Hello. And fake political observer, Prasad L. Han. Sun Singh Sarnal, the debacle, in your own words, you have 30 seconds. Go.
It's a great day for democracy. Ye democracy ki jeet hai.
How dare you? How dare you? You're an educated who comes to your art channel and gives us this glib. Rubbish. Rubbish. How dare you? Please, Yes, sir.
This is a sad day for democracy. I'm telling you, listen to me carefully. Today is the day when we will remember this day, because this is a sad, sad day for democracy.
Yes. I couldn't have put it better. I couldn't have said it better with more verb, more vitality, and more vigor. That's 3 weeks for the price of 1 week. I want to tell you, whole nation would like to hear that phrase once again, that first line.
So this is all ad-lib what he's doing, huh? This is not on script. This is all ad-lib.
The erudite, sophisticated spokesperson, a very Marcus Aurelius-like figure. So once again, let's hear it. Producer who's in my ear, but obviously larger than in my ear. Can you quickly play that once again? Loop it. Play it many times.
This is a sad day for democracy. This is a sad day for democracy. This is a sad day for democracy.
Super! We've got a point across, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, let's move on. Let's look at the elders in both the leading parties.
Yeah.
Give you an unbiased opinion.
So you actually have a plan show, right?
Yeah.
This will happen. Yeah, yeah. So there are a lot of times maybe there's an ad lib.
Yeah.
So how do you take care of that? For example, you have planned maybe a different shot and he's maybe speaking.
So now this thing, like repeated, was not a part of the script, but now because he has said it, how to make it funny? So that's why I made it like that bang and that neutral, negative effect and anything like that. So then you have to make it funny. Now it's his punch that he has delivered.
My question is, so for example, this is the shot, and immediately according to the script, it cuts to another shot.
Yeah.
But he's actually
no. So what happens is, so it's like, you're traveling from here to Churchgate, so ideally you will take the ceiling or whatever like that, but instead you go through Dadar and everything and you ultimately reach Churchgate. So he will start with the script, beech mein kahi jaake he will ultimately punch it to the point where I can use that shot, which is planned. So before, the planned shot will be there, but in between he might add something or anything, and then how we can use it, and if we can use it and develop it, like we use this looping thing. So I looped it, and so it became funnier.
Keep it rolling until unless he's actually done with.
Yeah, absolutely. So how you see it in a film or anything, ke ek dialogue hota hai, cut hota hai. Waise nahi, because we shoot on digital format, we can shoot how much ever we want. So then we can clean it up. So which is much more easier. So even the artist gets to, he gets free flowing and can do it, the performance, the way he wants to do it. And that's how we got this.
Against the Congress and the allies, because we believe in unbiased opinions favoring one side only. Let's meet this guy from the ruling party at the center. Unfortunately, not the ruling party in those five states. There he is, sir. Speak openly.
It is a conspiracy of the opposition. They have, Congress have purposely brought down the voting age. That is why kids are voting nowadays. Kids are voting nowadays.
You have spoken what we all wanted to speak, but you never had the courage to. So I salute you, but because both my hands are occupied right now, I'll salute you later. Let's go to this other gentleman for a contrary point of view, for which I'll give him not more than 5 seconds. Go.
It is a very nice day for democracy. The people have chosen their own leaders this time. It is the youth who has spoken about what should be, who should be.
Your time's up. You didn't get to the point here. You killed it right there. We like to have a balanced view, so we've done that. Now let's get an assortment of opinions, ladies and gentlemen, on nothing in particular. I want to just stress here. No other channel or journalist in the electronic media can do is give you balanced and different opinions at the same time on different topics, of which we didn't even bother to introduce at any point, the topic that is. And now, for final words on that fraudulent five-state election, we turn to Mr. Jai Pujari, who is not with the election commission. He has no official standing whatsoever, but he has to speak, and I will let him speak, because India needs to know. Go ahead, sir, go ahead.
I declared the five state results of Mizoram, Telangana, MP, Rajasthan and Chhattisgarh, and also Karnataka and Punjab from before, to be null and void and cancelled.
Words that have never been heard on a channel, null, void and cancelled. Excellent. And may I ask you, sir, Whose authority you cancel these elections on? Whose authority?
On your authority.
I'm going to do something here, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to pause for a second and I'm going to tone it down. I'm going to talk slowly and softly because I feel a poignant sense of almost happiness, almost joy that there's somebody out there who understands what went wrong with the system. And I'm going to applaud him, and I ask you and you and you everywhere to applaud with us. Let's have a 3-second applause moment together as a nation to applaud this man for cancelling those fraudulent election results. Alright, I'm just joining in for no reason whatsoever. But jokes apart, and he wasn't joking, jokes apart, we organize our own research and our own reactions after the semi-finals, as people are calling it, from this week. So let's welcome Janak Jagotia, JJ from BJP, and Samar Sagotia, SS from Congress. Now pause for a second, if you might argue, how can a Jagotia and a Sagotia, how can they be the same kind of names and represent two different parties? This is India. We all look the same and represent different parties. Here it is.
हाल कैसा है जनाब का क्या ख्याल है आपका
हम रेंज से कहिए तमीज से पैसा
हो हो यूं ही मचल गए हा हा हा
जीत गए तो देखिए हाल कैसा है जनाब का
साइरस 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 we know how to behave in victory. I have a peace offering for Janata.
Good. This is very good, sir. It's great because this is only business. It's only politics. And win or lose, you can still be friends. So go on, please. What is this peace offering?
Ruba, to wipe his tears. Dekhe, you may have won, but the Congress people have no class. No class. No. Class and caste agenda is BJP's birthright. Please keep it, huh? It is sad that people didn't understand your party's main objective.
Which is?
Corruption!
Guys, Jagotia! Just stop all this, yaar. Come on. Now tell me, Jagotia Saab, what went wrong in Rajasthan?
Aray, we are victims of Rajasthani laws.
Rajasthani laws? What is that?
No Rajasthan government can ever be re-elected by Rajasthani law. Aisi baat hai, to why did you contest in Rajasthan? Puche inse, maybe you made one big mistake.
What is that? What mistake?
BJP should have concentrated on camel instead of cow.
Let me ask you this one. Chhattisgarh, kya hua Chhattisgarh mein? What happened there?
We would have won, but for our one mistake.
Keep saying one mistake. Well, what was this one mistake? Please tell us.
Raman Singh. Lote huwe, aate hai sab. Inspector jo jayega, wo mukarne ka sikandar.
So if you are seen on a Hindi channel, they have this Mushaira kind of a thing, yeah, where they sing in front of the netas and all this kind of thing. So we thought, like, why not do a similar kind? So we figured out these songs. So we had, like, Cyrus had thought of the gag and everything, and we met in the morning. So we were like, hey, if we start, so Gopal was like, let's start with this. Hal kaisa hai janam? Yeah. Then we gradually like, idhar ye gana dal dete. So gradually the whole gag is about songs. And he is singing, like teasing the other guy. So which is very funny.
He has many mistakes across the country. Jaise ki Yogi Adityanath, Vijay Rupani, Jairam Thakur.
Yeah, okay, listen. Don't do that. Don't do it. That's not nice. Doesn't look good. Mr. Sagotia, let's be chivalrous here. And don't forget, you guys got hammered in Mizoram.
Are Sagotia doesn't even know the capital of Mizoram. What are you asking this duffer about Mizoram? And Jagotia should be warned that I may not know about Mizoram and Telangana, but I will make sure he is not allowed entry into Chhattisgarh, Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh. Because we won! Bach ke rehna re baba,
bach ke rehna re baba.
If the people want to take the country into reverse, they have done the right thing by voting Congress onto power. Of course we have to take India into reverse.
Take India into reverse? What are you saying?
We have to reverse demonetization, Aadhaar cards, Rajasthani textbooks. But first, we have to rename the renamed roads that BJP renamed.
Too much. So finally, Jagotia Saab, what have you learned from these campaigns? Tell us that. What have you learned?
I learned that the EVM machines that Sagotia told me were faulty 1 week ago are now perfect. But Jagotia, last week you disagreed with me, huh? But now you want the EVM machines which your government bought, to be checked and rechecked. This means BJP also knows how to reverse, eh?
Yeah, everyone knows how to reverse, but who will take our beautiful country forward?
It's a victory for corruption and the death of Vikas. Death of Vikas! By my condolences to Vikas and his family. Kya kar sakte? Rote, rote, hasna
seekho. Sing it again.
Haste, haste, rona. Wo jitni chabi bhari naam ne, utna chale khilona. Rote, rote, hasna seekho. By the way, you may have to keep your statues on hold, huh? Hello, hello, you worry about your own statue. Alliance with BSP comes with heavy price.
Guys, gentlemen, please stop all the bickering. Any final words, just tell us your final thoughts.
I humbly invite Jagotia to our victory party in Chhattisgarh, Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh. But I must warn him, alcohol may be served, huh? Chal, chal, mere bhai. Chal, mere bhai. Tere haath jodta.
No, mujhe nahi aana.
Haath jodta, tere paav padta hoon. Jiska
bada bhai. Arre, hum nahi hai
bhai aapke. Chota piye to kya hai khara.
Hum aapke bhai hai.
They may have won, but we are giving the people of India a bigger victory.
A bigger victory? What is that?
We are bringing back Vijay Mallya. Arre, we will win in Maharashtra and send him right back. Send you right back. No, 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 you can't. You can't. You have nowhere to send me. It's all ours.
We are the government.
Arre, don't know what government. Apni to aise taise.
See, I look at it, you can remove at least three reality shows from television right now. India's Got Talent, Indian Idol and Big Boss, and replace it with elections.
So that's now again in this also, he gets up, he's talking across the windows, and this music thing, you know, it, if you keep it English, it connects more easily to a lot of people, like you have a wider reach. So we try to keep it more English nowadays and get those kind of audiences more attracted to the show. First get your hand on writing and then learn how to storytell first. So which will always help you when you come to television. Unfortunately, thanks to the art of storytelling has died in television, but luckily at CNN News18 we are reviving it by our weekend programming, which is called Reporters Project and all. You please watch it, because it is about how you tell a story or what are the kind of stories which are happening still around. Like, be it the flesh trade which is happening in Haryana that we had done a special story on, then it was about the current one which we are working on is a surrogacy, the law which will be struck down by this thing, so we have done a special report on that, so which is a whole 20 minute report. So you know, you get to, a reporter also gets to tell the story the way they want to. Otherwise, like nowadays, it's only live. You see this reporter standing on the live and everything. So that's why we at least at our channel, we have dedicated the weekend for storytelling more. So like a storytelling or satire, or be it Rajiv's round tables, like entertainment, like dedicating that weekend, like when you are at home, ideally, you watch something which is different from the regular weekday programming that you're watching. And I think so that does connect with a lot of people. We are getting good responses in terms of number, because people do want to watch docu-based, like story-based things. Otherwise, if you go to see, it had recently died. Like, I don't think so a lot of, like, this reporter traveling in election-bound states, it's okay. It's been done over several years. It's again the same story, roti, kapda, makan, pani, farmer. That's the only story which is there. Get something more. There are a lot more underbelly stories. Like, I know for a fact that gradually this PUBG thing and how it's affecting people, it's gonna be another story.
Yeah.
It's gonna reach that point. It's that kind of that people have been killing and that kind of thing. So, like, there are these kind of stories, like surrogacy thing, like none of us would have thought, but when you are watching it on the channel and you'll come across it, so it's a different story than you'll see it in a news wheel. Then long form interviews also is what, if you have seen Anuradha Sen Gupta, she does this long form interviews called off center, so which are not this your regular people, like there was an Anupam Kher or something like that, but there are these other unknown people who have done something remarkably well, like Prakash Amte or someone like that, whom if you see the long format interviews, it's much more knowledge gaining than continuously this badgering in two windows or three windows or seven windows nowadays. God knows how many windows will be coming up, and that's how it is. So I would encourage you, because you're the upcoming listening, you should learn the art of storytelling, because that will help you go a long way. Because being an anchor or whatever, if you're a good storyteller, then you be a producer, you be a camera person, you be anyone, then you'll make sure that the job that you're doing it well, because you ultimately you want to tell a story. You don't want to pass a judgment, right? You want to convey a story. So it has to be in that way. Okay, don't do a story, like, ultimately, of course you have to do a story because your boss has asked you to do it. But also think about, like, when we had interns interning with us, they would use come and sit in the office and like be on Facebook or anything. So I used to tell them, boss, we come here to work. We haven't started an education institution that we'll come and make sure what you have done. Jab humko work milega, hum puchenge. But it's your duty to come to us, ask us if we are free, and have a discussion with us as to what you want to. So we'll tell you, come up with a story, or come tell us, give me five stories of the day or something like that. So now when you work in a national channel, you should have a national story. Like, the story should have a national appearance. Like, the BSC strike got into this thing after 2 days. So 2 days, the city of Mumbai was getting crippled. So that's why it became a national story. And ultimately went on to 9 days. So that's how the story got developed. Otherwise, till that time, no one actually called, haan, band hai, toh, aisa hota hai. So unless and until it affects, so you are like, there were a lot of people who came to me and said, sir, lower pal mein taxi nahi milti. A guy sitting in Delhi doesn't care, you don't take a, get a cab. You know, those are your city stories that will appear in a newspaper. But if I'll keep on telling you, work on a newspaper. So be it any beat, like BMC, crime, education. So once you work over there in a newspaper, you create your contacts in those beats. Then you develop, you start learning more about that beat. कि बीएमसी में स्टैंडिंग कमेटी में फिर कौन होता है, फिर कौन क्या पास करवाता है, फिर अगर जो मुंबई मेट्रो का है तो वो किसके अंडर जाता है क्या. सो दैट्स हाउ यू लर्न अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स. यू लर्न अ लॉट अबाउट पॉलिसीज, एंड व्हेन यू लर्न अ लॉट ऑफ अबाउट पॉलिसीज, यू नो विच टाइप ऑफ यू नो पॉलिटिशियंस आर कनेक्टेड टू इट, विच मिनिस्ट्री इट कम्स अंडर. सो दैट्स हाउ यू डेवलप एज अ रिपोर्टर. And the, like in terms of crime also, then how you realize, okay, which gang member, Dawood or whatever, Shakil. So that connection comes, because from the crime branch, then you will get that access. Or okay, ISIS ka ye bande ko neutralize kiya, ye kiya, wo kiya. So that's how you will develop. Television is very lucrative, but again, wahi hai. Don't look at the glamour that is there. You get ready, you become a solid product, then you'll sell anywhere. You create yourself into a product, then you'll be able to sell anywhere. That's why, like, tomorrow, you don't know, you might turn into a news bulletin director who plays a very important part. A news bulletin director is the guy who's the guide to the anchor, because he's his eyes and ears behind the camera. He will say, this package is ready, we have this reporter live, we have this guest live, and that's how he prepares the anchor to do the next toss. So you might have learned journalism, but because we have directors who have learned journalism, but they prefer this technical job because it's more hands-on onto the bulletin, like the visuals are coming in, get it cut fresh. So there are rundown, so he'll say, okay, I've sent you the visual, just play it right now. So which visual has to be played, or in with what window, does it need to be full frame or in a window with the anchor talking over it. So those are the factors. So a lot of, you know, these editorial technical collaborations are happening nowadays, and I would urge you to look at those options also, apart from just reporting, because you are still developing. You might get an edge when you start doing those kind of things also. You don't know. You like there are, if you go to see for NGC or for CNN also, there are a lot of producers who are reporters who are camera persons at the same time. So they shoot it on their own and they edit it on their own. Those kind of things also happen. So keep your mind open. There are a lot of opportunities in journalism. You guys didn't come to our office, right? Or, no? New faces I'm seeing, that's why. You guys haven't seen. We'll figure out. I'll figure out with ma'am if you can come to our office. We have to check with at our end first. So we can figure out a field trip so you can have a look at what a PCR looks like, and like in the studio where we shoot, it's in Lower Parel. So you'll get an idea how it all happens and get an idea about it.
So these points you made were about the general, topics, but how is the scenario when it comes to producing show for sports or something like that? How does that scene
happen? Now, if you're specifically about sports, so sports, a lot of restrictions come with in terms of your footage that is supposed to be used. Like any matches that happen in India, there are a lot of restrictions on it. Comparatively, Sony is more is not so hard press about certain regulations, so we can use it. But it's easier. So now a lot of the sports team in our office is quite less because the emphasis is on politics right now. But we have our website, which is Cricket Next or anything like that. So we keep on getting content from them. Like Gaurav recently joined back, so Gaurav is heading that thing. So he has done a Cheteshwar Pujara interview. Yeah. So that's a good thing. So that we are getting that content from there or whatever like that. But producing a sports bulletin, now you will say, okay, will I get to travel? Like if there's an Australia tour, will I be going? No. Obviously not. Either bet ke match dekho or jo unke so there is a press conference which happens after every match. So cut a bite out of it, and you can make a package for that matter. And the package is mostly about statistics, like Australia Open aaj jo match hua ya aage jo jaake match hone wala hai. To us hisab se you can make a news bulletin. Comparatively for an entertainment bulletin also, now we have technically stopped covering this launch, trailer launch, yeh launch, we have stopped doing it. Because why should we do it? So instead we do this news, like how, if you have seen, I don't know, E Now, with the international version E. So that, if you go to see, it's about who has done what, who has tweeted what, or, you know, in that angle, like as to what the actor is doing, his upcoming project or something like that. If the we don't do the first look, because nowadays before watching the bulletin, people have seen it on YouTube. So there's no use doing a first look of whatever, until we get it as an exclusive. But then we do stories like this. Then there was a entertainment story about, I don't know whether you guys have read it or not, that this one, Deepika Padukone has endorsed the Rajnigandha pearls. Deepika, I think so. No, sorry, Anushka. Anushka Sharma. Anushka Sharma has done it, and prior it was Priyanka Chopra. So someone has tweeted about it and everything. So see, that has also turned into a story. It's a simple tweet, and that tweet has turned into a story. So this could also happen. So these are also kind of stories that can pop up. Like you don't have to wait for a Supreme Court judgment or a politician to make any of this thing. Like sedition, this thing which happened recently, which was a very big news comparatively. So there are these big political news, there are these kind of news also. But now you have to choose your foray, like what you want to get into it. Like there could be a very good breaking that you can bring out of BMC also, you don't know. You can bring out a scam which has happened in allotting the, maybe the metro, this thing, or anything like that. Or the road redevelopment plan. That, so any scam, like recently, if you go to see, there is ultimately any story that you do, you should be able to sell that story to your editor or to your boss who's going to run it or who's going to print it. Because you should be able to sell it. You getting convinced that, boss, this is Taj Mahal is not important. Your boss should get convinced of Taj Mahal to put it on his tabletop. So that's very important. So you should know, like for me also, when I tell Kunal, let's do this story, I should be, first of all, my conviction should be that I should be able to convince him that this is a good story. Like when I told him Kumbh Mela, let's do it. It was my idea. Let's do a Kumbh Mela gag. Let's make Gopal into a sadhu or something like that. Then we developed it into this gag. What we saw, the gag. So, you know, apart from the self-conviction should be that I should be able to convince the others. Like, if you go to see, like a lot of anchors have that. You know, they'll convince you that this is what is the truth. You know, that is conviction. That's why a lot of politicians have it, and if you have it, then you'll be able to sell, use it for a better purpose, as in to sell your story. And your story should always be about two sides, about conflicts. What is the conflict about it? It shouldn't be judgmental, is what I would always encourage you to be, because then there will be someone who will be always there to contradict you. If you make a judgment, there is someone who will contradict that judgment. So don't make a judgment, just keep it flat. So there are, nowadays if you go to the pro, there are anti. So this will keep on happening. The best way is the middle one. Keep it neutral. You are a storyteller, you are a reporter, you have to report what is happening, not fabricate or support something that is happening. Anything else? So, no, writing is important. It is important because ultimately you will be able to that's what I told them, you'll be able to convey a story. Like like in a newspaper writing is what, 200 words an article, 300 words, whatever, like
3000 words.
Yeah, but like whatever, 3000 words. Then when you come to television, like we were doing till the last time when we were doing packages,
what's the main difference writing for television and writing for print?
So in print, you can write a whole page, like describe the whole thing. In television, you don't have that time, boss. Your story has to be told in 1.5 minutes, and precise 1.5 minutes. Not a second over it. We don't allow. Like, that's my job at the office, to cut it. So I'll cut your story.
You have to tell a story in 1.5 minutes.
Yes, along with the bites. Along with the bites in it.
The broadcast
piece. So I think so. Last time when I came, when I saw those packages, that time also I told them that it's the longer packages. No one has the time in the world to see longer packages about what is happening. Come on, serve it to me fast. So that's how the concept of speed news has also come now. The anchor keeps on reading over the visual what is happening.
You have people also who write packages, right?
Yeah.
So those are separate from the people who actually provide the input?
No, they have to be the same people.
How?
You're also
creating content and writing a whole package.
Yes. The reporter has to go on the field, shoot it, shoot the bites, shoot his PTC, come back, write the package.
For his story?
Yeah.
Each story is a package?
No, so it depends if the story needs to be packaged. Nowadays it depends if it needs to be packaged. Earlier we used to do a lot of packages. So now it has got cut down because a lot of shows are discussion, debate based shows. Earlier there were news bulletins where you will see package to be run. So now we prefer the reporter to write the story.
So you realize now what is a story to us print journalists is a package to the rest of you. That is the actual meaning.
Yeah.
Okay.
So.